Hello, and welcome back to another edition of WNHS TV. We're coming to you from all over Northern Calvert County on this crisp December day. I'm Quincy Barber.
And I'm Betsy Schlehuber. Today on the show, we have stories on the beginning of winter sports, on what students think of the growing popularity of astrology, on how people are celebrating the holidays during quarantine, on small shops and the beaches where you can find special presents, and we'll talk about decorating for the holidays. Here we go.
Some winter sports have recently started practicing at Northern, despite the pandemic. COVID won't stop these runners, swimmers, hoopers, and wrestlers. JoJo Hensley, Demetrius Mason, Blake Brown, Allison Hatfield, and I checked on the winter teams to see what they're doing to prepare and train.
Hey, I'm Coach E. I'm the head coach of the girls basketball program at Northern. So far, practice has been pretty good. It's been really difficult for everybody to kind of adjust wearing a mask. It's been different. You know, everybody's been 6 feet. Everybody's been spaced out. Everybody's been working hard, but it's difficult because the girls haven't been around each other for a while and we're just trying to get back in shape. So catching their breath after the sprints and getting used to putting your mask over your nose is something that has been a big adjustment period for us, but I'm sure they'll get used to it after a while. It's just hard playing basketball and wearing masks the entire time.
Hi, my name is Abby Lane. I'm a part of women's basketball. We have to wear a mask and we have to stay 6 feet apart. Sure. And they're not as fun because we can't play games. If there was no COVID, I think that we'd be better than we usually are.
I'm very hopeful that we'll be able to get a couple of games in so we can see where we match up against and how we match up against other teams in the county and the area. I think we just have way too many tools and pieces to be successful this year. I really wish we had a full season because I think we would have made a great playoff run.
My name's Ryan. I'm part of the swim team. They practice me different because we just have to wear masks on the deck and then we can take them off, of course, from the water. I think it's going to be competitive games. We just gonna have to be virtual, just like time lapses and stuff. And I think our team will do pretty well. Both boys and girls.
This is Trey Smith. I attend Northern High School. I'm also a part of the boys basketball team. They're extremely different. I mean, I think everybody knows you got to wear a mask and you can't scrimmage. You're limited to certain drills and activities. And I think the biggest takeaway is just being having to wear the mask and not be on a scrimmage. I think it's difficult. You're constantly nagging with it while you play. It's harder to breathe. There's so many problems that come with it. Do you think that you will play games in front of a crowd? I don't think that we will this year, based on how it's looking, even though I would love to. I hope we do, but I'm not sure, and I don't think that we will. Without a crowd, I think the energy is extremely different. You can feel it in the atmosphere. I think all athletes know that, and it's just so much more fun and enjoyable to play in front of a crowd. I think I'm going to go on to play college basketball. I just want to play another 4 years at any collegiate level. I have confidence and faith.
We'll make do with what we have. We have everything that we need to be successful. We're just making do with the circumstances that were given to us, and we're going to work hard regardless. Hey, I'm Coach E. I'm the head coach of the girls' basketball program at Northern.
When a child is born, determines their zodiac sign. Some people believe zodiac signs affect your personality, while others believe it's just a fun topic to talk about. Betsy Schlehuber, Jackson Blake, and I decided to ask students around Northern High about their opinions on astrology.
My sun is Pisces, my moon is Capricorn, and my rising is Scorpio.
I am a Sagittarius sun, Pisces moon, and Gemini rising.
My sun is in Gemini, my moon is in Capricorn, and I'm Pisces rising.
My zodiac sign is a Taurus, and I do not know my sun, moon, or rising sign.
My sun is in Aries, my moon is in Gemini, and my rising is in Cancer. And if you don't know what that means, your sun sign is the one you probably already know. It's just your basic personality and like yourself in a nutshell. And your moon is your deeper self or yourself behind closed doors. And then your rising is how you come off to other people and like first impressions.
If I had to choose my favorite zodiac sign, it'd probably be Sagittarius, because I'm Sag, or probably Capricorn, because most of my friends are Capricorns, they're super funny, and most of them actually don't believe in astrology, which makes it even more ironic.
My favorite zodiac sign is Aquarius because of how creative and carefree they can be, and I often wish that I had more Aquarius in my chart.
My favorite zodiac sign would have to be Pisces because I hear that they're portrayed to be intelligent and thoughtful with how they portray themselves.
My favorite zodiac sign is Cancer because that's what I am. And then the least favorite's Libras because they're all weird.
My least favorite zodiac sign is Virgo. Sorry. Because of how judgmental they are.
My least favorite is probably Cancer if I had to choose. I'm sorry, Cancers, but it's really moody and really indecisive, and I just don't like that in a person.
My least favorite would have to be Leo, because they're portrayed to be cocky and prideful, which isn't always good. I've never really seen that in any of my Leo friends, so who knows.
I would say my belief or like my spark of interest for astrology really started in probably about middle school, because I remember seeing a lot of stuff on social media about zodiac signs, and then from there I would like do research on it.
I've always been in astrology ever since I was like 5. My mom's been into it ever since I can remember, so it was just kind of introduced to me at a young age.
I have been into astrology for years, but I don't like use it to shape my everyday life or perception of others. I more use it for self-evaluation and to see what's happening in the universe at the time, like eclipses or transits or something like that.
I do not believe that astrology can govern my life. I think that's ridiculous. My dad and I had a conversation about it earlier today, and considering like how much time has passed since the zodiac signs were, you know, established and how all the stars have shifted and whatnot, it doesn't hold any relevance over my life, aside from being a fun way to entertain myself.
Astrology is just something that I look to for guidance, and it's a great tool to help you, just like to help me personally. Like, I use it to just be a better person in general, like with meditation and yoga, and all of that kind of goes hand in hand with like your zodiac sign and the phases of the moon.
I believe in zodiac signs the same way that I believe in tarot cards, which is that it's fun to look back upon and like have fun with, but I don't base it in any kind of fact or let it rule my life. It's all kind of based upon your perception of self, which can be altered.
Western astrology movement is a really great thing that has come to the U.S. because I think it's just encouraged a lot of people to be more mindful and open and get to know themselves better.
It's only human to be skeptical about these type of thing, but if you look deep into your chart, it really resonates. There's so much information about your birth chart and everyone is different, which I think is really cool.
I don't really believe in astrology, mainly because I live in a Catholic household. But if I were to believe in it, and what would change that, it would probably be if I wasn't a Catholic, because I'd be more accepting into astrology, because in the Bible it says for us to not believe in it. But I think it'd be very beneficial in my life and everyone around me.
It's basically like religion. Like, how are you going to convince somebody that God exists but that astrology is fake? Like, there's a god in the sky controlling everything, but I can't have a zodiac sign and I'm going to hell for believing in it. Like, it just doesn't make any sense.
I think from a more logical standpoint, and something that made a lot of sense to me was the fact that like people, human beings, are made of stardust, and so it would only make sense for the stars to have some sort of effect on us. And also, the moon controls all the water, all the tides on the planet, and people are 70% water, so the moon in specific definitely has an effect on people.
The only thing that could really change my belief about astrology would be if like a bunch of scientific studies came out proving it all and saying that, yes, this is accurate, you can trust it. The stars do govern your life, in fact. But until that happens, I'm good with just sticking as it being a fun little pastime.
To find your full birth chart, use astroseek.com. And it gives really in-depth information about each sign, the planet it's in, and then the house it's in. And it really, really resonates with me.
If you want to get more interested or more educated on zodiac signs, to definitely look on YouTube videos. There's a lot of good Spotify podcasts about astrology, and just any internet searching will get you really educated.
And also check out Maureen Altman on TikTok. She's a professional astrologer and is really credible.
If you're new to astrology, I definitely recommend downloading CoStar or any other astrology app.
I use an app called CoStar, which takes the date and time that you were born to give you daily readings, and you can also add your friends and check in with them of what they have going on. It's really cool, and I learned a lot more about Zodiac from it.
One thing I don't recommend, please don't use CoStar. There's no actual astrologers on their team, and I know a lot of people use CoStar, but it's actually not fun. Their notifications can be really anxiety-inducing, and they don't know what they're talking about.
If you don't believe in astrology, that's fine. Just don't judge me or anybody else because we do. And, or maybe you can, just in your head. You don't have anything nice to say, don't say it at all.
As the holiday seasons are coming up, this is supposed to be the best time of the year, correct? But celebrating Christmas in the middle of a pandemic might make it harder to feel like it's the best time of the year. Lexi Bingham, Dana Serum, Mackenzie Nicholas, T.G. Lattimore, and I have found out how some students are planning to make the most of this Christmas season. Jingle bell, jingle
bell, jingle bell rock. My favorite thing we do for Christmas is how the day after Thanksgiving we decorate our entire house very aggressively, and then we also include some Jewish traditions because my grandpa is from Israel, so we also celebrate Hanukkah.
One of my favorite traditions for the holidays is that me and my family have a set of like angels and baby Jesus and all of that, like little statues, and we take the little baby Jesus statue, and each year a different person in the family gets to hide the statue. And this year it's my year, so I'll get to hide the statue wherever I want in the house. I usually choose my room because it's where I know the best places to hide things.
One of my favorite movies for the holidays are the Home Alone movies because I have fond memories watching them with my brothers around the holidays.
Family Christmas tradition me and my family do is go all down to my grandparents' house in North Carolina and open a present on Christmas Eve all together, and bake cookies for Santa, I guess. And it's a really good time, and I love my family.
Well, my family this year, we have no travel plans. We're just gonna stay home so we can stay safe and just have close family over.
My favorite Christmas memories is every year on Christmas Eve, we live by the beach, and we usually walk down to the beach on Christmas Eve, kind of in the afternoon when it's still light out. And some of my favorite memories are when we were little. Like, there were some years when Christmas was very mild, and like, me and my brothers would go swimming in our clothes at the beach because it was so mild and the weather was nice. And I just have memories of coming back to the house sopping wet, and it was Christmas Eve, and being so excited for the holidays.
COVID has affected our travel plans. We tend to go out of state for Thanksgiving or even out of the country sometimes. But yeah, this year we're not, but it's okay. Specific Christmas memory, but I love everything leading up to Christmas, like going to see lights and ice skating with my friends and family. That's definitely my favorite part. Jingle bell, jingle bell,
jingle bell rock. During this pandemic, many small businesses are struggling to stay open, and we all need to do our best to make sure these businesses make it past the holiday season and into 2021. Betsy Schleyhuber, Paige Platter, Jaden Brown, Skylar Shaner, and I have found the best gifts to buy from some small businesses in North Beach.
Our first shop is located in North Beach, Maryland. The Bay Shop, which opened a few months ago, is run by business partners Nancy and Carrie. This shop has a diverse group of products and gifts great for all your friends and family. We got the chance to sit down with one of the owners, Nancy, to hear about some of their products.
Our store is a local gift shop. We have 36 to 38 local crafters and artisans that sell out of our space. Most products are handmade. Most of our items are very unique. Some things can't be found anywhere else. Right now we're gearing up for, of course, for the holidays, so a lot of our items were Christmas related and gift giving items. We sell to people who want to decorate their home, because we have a lot of local nautical style home decor. We market for baby gifts, handmade and unique. We're working on directing more items towards male customers and brides, weddings. So we want to be specialty.
At Bay Shop, a lot of time and thought is put into each product.
I know a candle maker, she says it's 2 weeks for her soy candles to cure up. The woman that does our pottery, it's a 3 to 4 step process. And our vendors do custom orders. Most of them will do custom work for a client if there's something specific that they want. We have a whole dog pet section for our four-legged furries that come in. We're also dog friendly. I would probably recommend something that is more unique to the area we're in. We have hand-painted crab ornament. Also oyster shells that are local to the Chesapeake Bay. A little bit for everybody. Price ranges go from $3 to $300, so there's certainly something in here you can find.
The next destination on our list is Lighthouse Market and Signs. This is a family-owned business that has been here for 19 years. They sell gifts, t-shirts and sweatshirts, nauticals, toys, garden flags, and more. Lighthouse Market is here to accommodate anything you forget when coming to the beach, but they still have products for you to buy during the holiday season. They have ornaments, toys, and much more. This is a place where everyone can shop, from kids to seniors. You can visit Lighthouse Market and Signs from 11 to 5, Monday through Saturday, and 11 to 4 on Sundays. Next up is Sister's Corner. Kathy and her sister Carol opened the store in 2007. Sister's Corner has lots of different items for the holiday season. They sell giftware, home decor, fashion accessories, and local food items. Showcased throughout the store on Christmas trees are the assortment of ornaments the store carries. The store's gift items are divided by specific family member and friends, making it easier for you to shop for gifts. Their holiday-themed merch and decorations are perfect for the holiday season. Our final store is located in Chesapeake Beach, Maryland. Calvert Kettlecorn offers a wide variety of popcorn flavors that make a unique and fun holiday gift. The store also sells Christmas ornaments, t-shirts, socks, masks, hats, and more. They offer different tins to choose from for holding your popcorn, and though they permanently closed their North Beach location, they're still running smoothly, getting all their popcorn from their store in Charlotte Hall. Check out all of these businesses in the community, not only for the holiday season, but year-round. Also, be sure to check their websites for information about their Christmas Eve and Christmas hours.
To spread holiday cheer, people all over Northern Calvert have decorated their houses, from a few strings of light to a whole performance. People in this area get pretty creative. Owen Adriani, Louisa Richardson, Elena Stewart, Morgan Kolk, and I decided to take a look and see what people in Calvert County do to decorate.
When it comes to decorating for Christmas with my family, we've just always decorated, even when it was just me and my mom. We've always decorated, even though a lot of the decorations we have this year, we got this year because a lot of the decorations from last year we lost, or a lot of the ornaments broke.
I decorate my house. How long have I been decorating my house? For as long as I can remember. Even as a little girl, I was always outside helping my father decorate the house. Christmas is definitely one of my favorite holidays.
So my family, personally, we don't decorate too much around the house. We just usually just do the tree and the stockings, and that's basically it. So just because we never really have enough time to like really enjoy it.
My favorite part of decorating is after it's all done, at my age now, seeing my daughter's eyes light up when she goes outside to see it all lit up and come together for the very first time. I also really like watching my neighbors slow down in front of the house to admire all the pretty lights and decorations. And I've even seen some of my neighbors hop out and take a selfie with the decorations behind them. So that always makes me feel really good, and that's one of my favorite parts.
Yes, I do decorate my house every single year around the holiday season. And I have been decorating it for about 5 years. And then before that, we decorated the house we had before.
How did I get started? Definitely as a little girl, my father was very much into decorating our house, the house I grew up in as a child, and I watched him do it, and I always looked forward to watching him decorate and seeing it all come together and the final product.
We usually decorate the same way every year. We always start with the piano and then the fireplace and then the shelves and then the tree. We always do the tree last.
I always have a vision before I go out and get started. And my husband certainly contributes to this vision. He's very creative, as I am when it comes to decorating the house.
So my favorite thing about other Christmas lights and stuff like that, it's the ones that tell a story are like really big and elaborate. I think those are really awesome to look at, and I really enjoy watching those. Just like the different light shows and everything like that. Especially like if I go over to a friend's house when they have the inside decorations, I think those are amazing. Just because sometimes they tell a family tradition that keeps going down. I think it's really neat how it keeps getting passed down.
Yes, it is definitely a tradition in my household. And I decorate because it makes me happy. It brings a smile to my face. It brings a smile to my family's face, as well as my neighbors.
My favorite part about Christmas decorating during the holiday season is that everybody takes time out of the out of their day and out of their busy schedules to just kind of get together. And we usually have Christmas music playing or something baking, and it's always really pleasant, you know?
My opinion on house lights, I think they're really cool. Like I said before, they're really neat to watch, and I really enjoy it. But me personally, when I grow up and do other things, I probably won't put house lights on, just because I probably won't have enough time to enjoy them like we do now.
Merry Christmas and happy holidays. I hope everybody has a safe, healthy, and wonderful winter break. You deserve it.
That's it for this week's show, Patriots. It's the holiday season and the weather is finally changing. Please make sure to dress warm and connect with friends and family over the next few weeks. Remember, there's still a deadly virus going around. Wear a mask, stay home, save a life. I'm Quincy Barber.
And I'm Betsy Schlehuber. The holidays are finally here. We have 7 days off from school. That's 11 straight days till we have to log on again. Have a Merry Christmas. If you celebrate Hanukkah, we hope you had a wonderful time. If you celebrate some other way, we hope you have a good break. And remember to follow Northern Journalism on Twitter at NHS Patriot Press to stay updated on all things NHS. That's it for us. Tune in next year for a new edition of WNHS. We'll see you in 2021.